Sardinia, the Footstep of the God, which is being held in Joseph Gazzuolo Fine Arts Gallery in Fine Arts Center of North Hennepin Community College, Brooklyn Park, Minnesota, USA. It features the works of two artists, Yelena Kurdyumova and Sergey Porada, members of International Federation of Journalists who traveled to Sardinia on the invitation of the Ministry of Tourism for promotion of the island. Sardinia is an autonomous region of Italy with a special status. Sards are confident of divine genesis of their land. They believe that their island, reminding in the shape of a human footstep, was the first step of the god who stepped on this island and started the creation. Geologists and archaeologists agree with them and assert that Sardinia could become the first place in Europe inhabited by men. Sardinia wasn't discovered by tourists until 1960s, and even now it isn't known for many. This is our third exhibition since November 2016, and we are getting Americans acquainted with this unique and beautiful island with ancient history. Sardinia is famous for its 5,000-year-old and even more historical sites. The excavations were started in the middle of the 19th century and brought tremendous success to the island. Archaeological excavations in the middle of the 19th century brought to light Nuraks. Nurak is a Bronze Age megalithic conical tower built of huge rectangular rocks, often surrounded by a Nurakic village. Boromini Nuragi dates back to the 15th century BC. Outside village was built about the 12th century BC. There are more than 7,000 Nuraks on the island, which are over 3,500 years old, but most of them haven't been excavated yet. It is a mystery how ancient people without construction equipment could lift huge rocks on 50 feet height. The purpose and use of these towers is uncertain. Most likely, they were defensive fortresses, palaces, or temples at the same time. In any case, the Nuragi represented a center of social life. On this photo, you can see Nurag from the other side. This is Nuragic village. Low constructions resembling a maze of small stone rooms built in around 12th century BC. The walls are still preserved, and of course there are no roofs which couldn't stay for so long time. Another wonder which was excavated are ancient tombs of giants. Tomb of Giants is an impressive stone building belonging to 2,500 years BC, which served as a megalithic gallery grave used as public tomb for the residents of nearby villages, Nuragis. The highest and well-preserved Stonehenge is located near the town of Erzacena in the north of Sardinia. Flat oval center stone of pink granite is 4 meters tall and about 2 meters wide, and a few stones on the sides shield the entrance to the 10-meter long stone gallery, which served as a burial place. In the center of the monolith, a small hole was cut out, symbolizing the door to the underworld. Stretching beyond the horizon, vineyards produce the grapes, of which Cantina Capicera Winery makes some of the best wines in Italy. This is Cantina Capicera Winery, near ancient tomb of giants. Its image is shown on the wall of winery testing room. Located near Porto Cervo, this winery makes some of the best wines in Italy. In Capicera Winery, we found a set of winery tools which were used in ancient times to make wine. Sardinia is remarkable for an unusually diverse terrain, bizarre landscapes, and beaches with the cleanest and clearest waters of the Mediterranean. The total length, 1,150 miles, is a quarter of all the beaches of Italy, and without a doubt, the most beautiful of them. There are still completely untouched by civilization corners of paradise, with golden sands and secluded rocky coves next to modern hotels. This is Wild Beach near Forte Village Resort. It's called Silver Beach for the color of the water in the sea. Sardinia has very diverse landscape, valleys and high mountains and a long beach coastal line. The highest mountain in Sardinia is Punta La Marmora, which is 1,834 meters high, which is approximately 6,016 feet. Near La Marmora, there is a ski resort, which is open in winter. And it's also famous for the deepest canyon in Europe, which is over 400 meters deep. The name of the canyon is Garopo, and it's very famous among rock climbers who come here to climb its almost vertical walls. Combination of sea and mountain air creates a special climate, good for fast recovery of strength. No wonder most of Italian 100-year-olds live on Sardinia. Swimming season lasts from May to November. In summer, the temperature often rises to 30 degrees Celsius, which is approximately 86 degrees Fahrenheit. However, winds blowing through the island all year round don't allow residents and visitors suffer from heat and humidity and create ideal conditions for kiting and other aerial sports. There are many watch-out towers along the coastal line of Sardinia. They are also very old, about 2,000-3,000 years before Christ, and they were used by ancient Sards to protect their land from invaders from other countries around. The northernmost point of Sardinia, from where you can see the French island of Corsica, is Capa Testa. It will capture the imagination of the most seasoned traveler and experienced photographer. Winds constantly blowing through the cape from all sides carved out whimsical sculptural compositions out of huge pink cream granite rocks that resemble enormous heads. Testa means head. They resemble figures of animals, domes of cathedrals, and even giant profiles of celebrities. Juniper bushes punch between the boulders, and the bases of many food sculptures are decorated with bright yellow, purple, blue, and red wildflowers. The only sign of civilization is a lighthouse, which fits well in color and form in the fabulous granite park. This is another view of Capa Testa Lighthouse arising amid whimsical stone sculptures. This is an old fishing boat against another beautiful view of Capa Testa stones. The hotel building is nicely worked into the landscape, and at the backdrop of this scenery, in the upper left corner, you can see the figure of the bear stone, very popular in these places. This is the downtown of Tempia Poazania. the city in the north of Sardinia, in the mountains. It was built at the beginning of the 18th century, and since then it is the granite center of the island. This is the sculpture near the entrance to Trattoria Balbacana, which means restaurant of natural food. We made it the face of our exhibition. This is a pine tree near Garibaldi's home, Casablanca, on small island of Caprera in the archipelago of La Maddalena, part of Sardinia. This island is famous as the place to which the national hero of Italy, General Giuseppe Garibaldi, retired in 1854. He bought the island in 1855 to settle there and planted himself the first pine trees which cover the island today. In such a beautiful and peaceful setting, Garibaldi could ponder and plan the expeditions which eventually led to the birth of the Italian Republic. Perhaps the untamed beauty of Sardinia, matching proud temper of Sardes, made him return to Sardinia again and again. Garibaldi was buried in 1882 in the park of his home, Casablanca. His house is now a museum and a memorial chapel, and the island itself is a national monument. This is a spectacular panoramic view of the island of Tavolara from Hotel Don Diego. The water around the island is a popular spot for scuba diving. The island is located near Costa d'Arata, northeast of Sardinia, province of Olbia. One part of it has almost vertical walls with beautiful caves inside. This is another view of Tavolara Island from Don Diego Hotel, located in San Paolo, Costa d'Arata. This is the view of Colonna Grand Hotel in Capoterra. It's remarkable for the silver waters of Silver Bay on the shore which it stands. You will find on Sardinia a mixture of Mauritanian, Spanish and Roman styles, ruins of ancient cities from the ages of flourishing of Roman Empire. The main cities were founded in the Phoenician, Carthaginian and Roman periods of history. Among them is Cagliari, 7th, 6th century BC, modern capital of Sardinia, and Olbia, 6th, 4th century BC, a large city and port in the north of the island. This is an old fortress in the downtown of Cagliari, administrative center of Sardinia. The capital of Sardinia, Cagliari, surprisingly combines all the attributes of a modern city and a important port with ancient ruins, narrow streets, and Carthaginian fortifications. We found this cat was completely different to white mice around him in the Cagliari downtown, and he seemed to us an unexpected addition to many attractions of Cagliari: the medieval castle, the cathedral of Santa Maria in Bonaria, typical medieval quarters with residences of wealthy families, and the Roman amphitheater. This is a glimpse of a street in the city of Palau. Palau is city and port in the north of Sardinia. From this city, a ferry goes to Archipelago La Maddalena, where Memorial House, Museum, and tombs of Garibaldi and his family are located. Sofitel Talassa Tiniama, an exclusive resort in the south of Sardinia in the Bay of Tiniama, which means in the language of Sardes, fear of love. According to ancient legend, in this place, beautiful sirens fascinated fishermen with their singing. The resort is located on the shores of the salt lake Nateri, which is separated from the sea only by a narrow strip of crystal clear sand. Porada was famous for its Thalassa Center, which offers a complex of therapies, Thalassa therapy, based on the combination of seawater properties and the latest technologies. These wild horses live on Giardi Kisturi, a high and steep-sided basaltic plateau which extends for about 42 square kilometers, which is 16 square miles, in the southern central part of Sardinia Island. Sards say that centuries ago there was a shipwreck and the horses swam to Sardinia, to the island, to save their lives. And later, Sards used these horses in fall. They gathered crops and they needed horsepower to rotate the millstones. They caught wild horses and used them. And when the season was over, they set them free. When new season came, the whole story repeated. Nowadays, of course, they don't do anything like this, but the horses, which are wild, have a fear of people in their genes. I was photographing a road race and I was standing with the back to this meadow when I felt that someone was watching me. When I turned around, I saw two beautiful wild horses which were watching me and the race. And I was able to take only two photos when they disappeared. This is the dessert which is served in Hotel La Palma. This Hotel La Palma is located in Porta Cervo in the north of Sardinia, in Costa Smeralda, Emerald Coast. Ecologically clean food and beautiful decorations are distinguishing features of Sardinian cuisine. Forte Village, one of the sportiest resorts in Sardinia, is located in a luxurious tropical park on 25 hectares. From May to September, children ages from 4 to 13 are invited to a week-long training course in the school of Chelsea Football Club. The modern version of the famous Roman baths terms is called Thalassa Therapy Center, Thermi del Forte Village. It offers a unique muscular and psychological relaxation. The prestigious football clubs Inter, Juventus, Bavarian Munich, and the national teams of England and Germany trust centers professionals caring for the health of their players. This is the entrance to historical Roman thermal baths at Forte Village Resort. Pink flamingos are the sign of clean air and water, and there are a lot of them all over the island. The resort is famous for its Thalassa therapy. There are seven pools in the resort. The temperature starts from very hot pool with a lot of natural oils dissolved in the water. Then you can transfer to another pool with less temperature and less oils. And finally, in the seventh, the temperature of the water is original, which is currently in the sea near the resort. There are a lot of massage streams in the pools. In the resort, there are several saunas from different cultures, like Finnish sauna, Roman therma, and Turkish sauna. And the whole set of these Thalassa therapies gives exquisite muscle relaxation and psychological relaxation. That is why
the players from the leading European soccer teams train and rest in Forte Village. It has a lot of other amenities like karting, bowling, roof skating rink, and a very beautiful sand beach. The resort is located in Santa Margherita di Pula. It's a bay and it has its own microclimate with the temperatures like 2 or 4 degrees higher than in other resorts on the coastal line of Sardinia.
Sardinia wasn't discovered by tourists until 1960s, and even now is unknown to many. Until recently, Sardinia remained the island of billionaires, celebrities, and politicians. Costa Smeralda, Emerald Coast, is considered a private club of world's elite. Porta Cerva is the heart of the resort. Suites are beautifully decorated and some of them have private swimming pools. The assortment of boutiques on famous Plaza Piazzetta in Porta Cerva will strike at the heart the most sophisticated lovers of shopping. This is another view of Porta Cerva Hotel. The deck of the hotel is decorated with the picture symbolizing day and night, and it opens up the view of a large green park surrounding the hotel. There are no skyscrapers or tall buildings on Sardinia. This is a hotel in Porta Cerva, famous resort city in the north of the island. It looks more like a cluster of private homes which are 2-3 stories high, and they are worked into the landscape very naturally. These hotel buildings don't dominate over the hills. They look like a part of them and create a very cozy and natural impression. That's why we call this view Mediterranean paradise. The cluster of hotel suites naturally climbs the hill. They're built of natural stone. That is why it's always cool inside such little house. The territory is decorated with wild natural stones from Capa Testa, and the water in the lakes and ponds around is so still and glassy that it gives a wonderful reflection of the whole structure. And that's why we called this image reflection. This is the inside patio of Porta Cerva Hotel. It's decorated with natural stones from Capa Testa, which is not far from Porta Cerva, and the siding of the walls is also made of natural stones. Wildflowers are found everywhere. Porta Cerva is the heart of Costa Smeralda, the Emerald Coast. Here, the number of yachts of distinguished guests dazzles the eyes. The assortment of boutiques on famous Plaza Piazzetta will strike at the heart the most sophisticated lovers of shopping. Costa Smeralda is the most northern part of the island of Sardinia. And Porta Cerva is the heart of Costa Smeralda. Over the last 30-40 years, its picturesque, rocky shore, cozy bays with transparent emerald water, surrounded by emerald hills, became the place where international
sailing regattas are held, and the resort itself became well known in Europe and all over the world. This is Santeri, rural area in the south of Sardinia. It's famous for its grotte zudes, a cave where you can see stalagmites and stalactites, and which is enjoyed by tourists from all over the world. This area is remarkable for plantations of cork trees, where Sards get cork for the wine industry. The cork is cut from the surface up the trunk, up 3-4 feet. And the trees stay alive, they continue growing and they give new cork during their lifetime. This area is remarkable for herds of lean wild pigs and long-tailed sheep resting under the cork trees. Such sheep are found only on Sardinia. Near Grotte Zudes there is a restaurant where you can try cuisine of done of the meat of wild pig. And the herds of these wild pigs wander around in the woods. Finishing the presentation of our exhibition of 34 photos, Sardinia, the Footstep of the God, telling about our two expeditions to Sardinia Island in the team of 20 well-known sports and travel journalists and photographers with European background, we suggest purchasing our photos by contacting us through Contact Us page on our website runglobaltranslate.com. Any of these photos can be printed in three techniques, providing UV and scratch protection: aluminum canvas, Fuji pearl paper mounted on board. The price depends on the size, printing technique, framed or unframed. Our photo portfolio is available on international professional website photographersdirect.com. by searching professional photographers listings in North America, USA, Minnesota, Yelena Kurdyumova and Sergey Porada. Direct link to our portfolio is photographersdirect.com/Kurdyumova-Porada. To see about 360 of our photos, enter our initials SPYK into the search window on the main page or website photographersdirect.com. All these photos can also be printed in three techniques: aluminum, canvas, and Fuji pearl paper mounted on board. We also suggest contacting us through Contact Us page on our website runglobaltranslate.com for participation in our Sardinia Trip Photography Workshop in April-May 2018, and for help in the organization of educational tours and individual leisure tours to Sardinia Island. Also contact us for concluding an agreement on curating and promotion of art exhibitions, including production of HD video presentations of exhibitions.